We're going to take the region between y equals 2x and y equals x squared, and we're going to revolve it around a bunch of different axes to see how that changes. And we're going to do each of these solids of revolution with both the washer method and the shell method so that we can compare and contrast the setup for both of these methods. Let's first look at y equals 2x and y equals x squared around the x-axis using the washer method. For using the washer method, it means that we need to make our slices perpendicular to the axis of revolution. So here's a typical rectangle. If we revolve it around our axis, we get a washer like this. For the washer method, we know that volume is equal to the integral of the region. So this region in the x direction goes from 0 to 2 of pi outer radius squared. So the outer radius is the distance from the farther away function to the axis. Here, our farther away function is the red function. So that's 2x minus our axis is 0 squared. So that's pi outer radius squared minus pi inner radius squared. So our inner radius is the distance from the closer function to the axis. The closer function is x squared. So x squared minus our axis is 0, and then dx. Now let's look at the same solid of revolution using the shell method. For using the shell method, we want to cut parallel to the axis of revolution. We revolve it around, and we get this shell that looks like the label on a soup can. Now, with the shell method, our volume is equal to the integral of the region. So here we're using y values, so the region goes from 0 up to 4 of 2 pi radius. Now remember, the radius is the distance from the slice, here the slice is at y, to the axis, so the axis is at 0, so y minus 0. So that's the radius times the height. The height of the shell is the length of this slice. So this is a horizontal distance, so we're going to do right minus left, blue minus red. Now we're integrating in terms of y, so we solve for x so that we have a function in term of y. So the blue function is now going to be x equals the square root of y. It's the positive square root because it's on the positive side of the y-axis. And the red function is now going to be x equals 1/2 y. So we're going to do blue function minus red function, so square root of y minus 1/2 y dy. And those two integrals are going to give you the exact same answer because they're finding the volume of the exact same region. Now let's revolve the same region around the line y equals negative 1. How does this change it? Let's use the washer method first. The washer method means we need to cut perpendicular to the axis. So when we cut perpendicular to the axis, it looks something like this. It's a washer, big circle with a little circle cut out of the middle. And we know that volume then is the integral of the region. So the region in x is going from 0 to 2 of pi outer radius squared. So the outer radius is the distance from the farther away function to the axis. And that distance is the red from the red function to the axis. So the red function is y equals 2x, and the axis now is negative 1. So we do 2x minus a negative 1 squared, it's the outer radius squared, minus pi, the inner radius squared. So the inner radius is the distance from the closer function to the axis. Since we're in terms of x, the closer function here is x squared minus the axis, which is still negative 1. And then a dx at the end. Now let's find the same volume of a solid of revolution using the shell method. With the shell method, we want to cut parallel to our axis. So now that we have a horizontal rectangle, that means we're integrating in terms of y. So volume is equal to the integral, the y bounds of the region, so 0 to 4. Note there is no rectangles between negative 1 and 0, so we don't include that. 2 pi. And now we need the radius. The radius of this shell is the distance from the slice down to the axis. So that's the distance from y to negative 1. So we have y minus negative 1. And then the height is the height of the rectangle. So that's the same horizontal distance as before. Remember, we have the blue function minus the red function, but remember we have to be in y, so that's square root of y minus 1/2 y dy. Now, let's do the same region around the line y equals 5. How does that change things? So now, let's first use the disk washer method. So we cut perpendicular to the axis, and it's going to go way up here. And we're going to have volume equals the bounds of integration. We're based on the region, so that's still 0 to 2. Pi. Outer radius squared. So now what's the outer radius? Which function is farther away? Well, now that our axis is above, the farther away function is x squared. So we have x squared is the farther away function, and 5 is our axis. Now we want the distance from x squared to 5. But the problem is, notice that 5 is actually bigger than x squared. We're trying to find a vertical distance here, so we need to do top minus bottom. And then we're going to subtract from that pi, the inner radius squared, dx. So what's the inner radius? The inner radius is the distance from the closer function to the axis. So this is the distance from 2x to 5. But again, this is a vertical distance, so we do top minus bottom. So it's 5 minus 2x because the 5 is on top. Now let's do the same solid using the shell method. Using the shell method, we want to cut parallel to the axis. So revolving a typical slice will give us something like this. So volume is going to be the integral of the region. So in the y values, this region goes from 0 to 4. Note that there's no rectangles between 4 and 5, so we don't include that. Of 2 pi, now the radius here is the distance from the slice at y to 5. But notice this is again a vertical distance, so we want to do top minus bottom. So now we're going to do 5 minus y because 5 is on top. And then the height of the shell is the height of length of this slice, so that is still square root of y minus 1/2 y dy. Now let's do the washer method around the line x equals negative 1. Now we need to do perpendicular to the axis is going to be a horizontal. So washer means perpendicular to the axis. Horizontal means we're in terms of y. So our integral is going to go from 0 to 4, because those are the y values. And we're doing the washer method, so it's pi outer radius squared. The outer radius is the distance from the farther away function to the axis. That distance is given in terms of y. So the farther away function here is the square root of y minus the axis is negative 1. The square root of y comes first because it's right on the right side, and we do right minus left, minus pi the inner radius squared. The inner radius is the distance from the closer function to the axis. So that's the red function. So that's 1/2 y minus negative 1 dy. Now let's do that same region using the shell method. Using the shell method, we want to cut parallel to the axis. So we have volume equals the integral. Now we use the x values of the region from 0 to 2 of 2 pi, the radius. Now the radius is the distance from the slice, which is at x, to the axis. So that distance is the radius, so that's going to be right minus left, x minus a negative 1. And then the height of this rectangle is just top minus bottom, 2x minus x squared dx. All right, let's do one more. Let's revolve this region around the line x equals 3. Using the washer method, we want to cut perpendicular to the axis. So we're going to have volume equals the integral. And since we have horizontal rectangles, we're using y values from 0 to 4. Pi outer radius squared. So the outer radius is the distance from the farther away function to the axis. So the farther away function here is going to be 1 half y. But again, notice that this distance right here is a horizontal distance, so we want to do right minus left. So it's going to be 3 minus 1 half y. And then we're going to subtract from that pi inner radius squared dy. So the inner radius is going to be the distance from the closer function to the axis. But again, this is a horizontal distance, so we want to do right minus left. The right is 3, and the left is square root of y. In our last example, we want to do the same volume using shells. So we cut parallel to the axis. We have volume equals the integral from 0 to 2, because that's where our rectangles are going to be, of 2 pi radius. So the radius is the distance from your typical slice at x to your axis at 3. So this distance here, it's a horizontal distance, so it's 3 minus x, right minus left, times the height of that rectangle, which is just 2x minus x squared times our dx.